evening, good evening. So I was actually about to wind down, and I'm holding my phone because I was actually, you know, about to get into work myself and kind of wind down and everything, and I just had this encounter with God, and I just said, okay, Lord, I need to let everybody know of your goodness and everything, and I was going to actually bring this word, like, later. I was thinking tomorrow, so like, okay, you know, I'll, you know, fix myself up, you know, whatever, you know, and because I've been, like, doing some things today, of course, you know, working out and stuff like that, so, I just wanted to, you know, after I was rested, because I was in prayer all last night and stuff like that, so I was like, after I rested out, you know, would bring this word, but I just had this encounter with God, and I was just like, you know what, it doesn't matter what Teresa looks like or anything like that. It's all about getting the word out and the faithfulness of God. So let's go into prayer right quick, and it won't be long, but I just, you know, want to share. I posted Matthew 13:44-46. We'll read that quickly. I'll release what he gave me about 2 days ago, and actually he confirmed it through somebody else just talking and everything, and I was like, you're confirming what God told me, and, but anyway, so Father, I just thank you. I thank you for your Holy Spirit, God. I thank you that you're guiding us in this hour, that when we find the pearl, as you found the pearl, may our hearts be willing to give up everything.
Clarity and search
of your spirit and everything that comes with your Holy Spirit. May we be
like those great
merchants in the parable that
we're about to read.
Let your word touch the heart that's supposed to touch as we go into
this.
I'm reading from the Passion's Translation, guys, but it says, Heaven's kingdom realm can be illustrated like this. A person discovered that there was a hidden treasure in a field. Upon finding it, he hid it again. Because of uncovering such a treasure, he was overwhelmed with joy and sold all he possessed to buy the entire field just so he could have the treasure. Heaven's kingdom realm is also like a jewel merchant in search of a rare pearl. When he discovered one very precious and exquisite pearl, he immediately gave up everything he had in exchange for it. So, in this parable, and you know, like I said, God spoke in parables, because like he told the disciples, you're with me, you have the understanding, but he liked to speak in parables because that's an invitation for us to go deeper and dive into what his Holy Spirit is trying to tell us. But you know, God's word is living, and he always, again, if you go deeper, will give you more revelation on it. You know, scholars and everything, they were saying that the pearl was us, you know. The pearl was us, and Jesus, you know, sold everything. He bankrupted heaven to come and give his life because of the treasure that was set before him, and that was us and everything. And, you know, he's the one that leads the 99 to go after that one soul, and the Bible talks about that all of heaven rejoices when one sinner, one lost person comes to know Christ, right? And, you know, so I was meditating on that and everything, and God gave me a word, you know, and I was like, you know, going over the word, and then that, and he was just saying that he wants us, because we're supposed to be mirror images of Christ, right? When we're born again, when we accept Jesus in our life, we supposed to become the hands and feet of Jesus. We supposed to be the ones that, you know, do his work, his bidding here, you know, in heaven, you know, allowing time to hear his voice, learning to spend time with him in his word, so we can actually go out and help him bring in the treasure that he died for. Now, those are lost souls and everything, you know. And, but it costs so much, you know. And again, the Bible tells us those of us that are hitting within Christ, then we have to pick up our cross and do the things that he's called us to do. And it's not, all the things are not easy, but again, we are victorious. He teaches us through all the trials and tribulation he has us to go through and things like that. You know, even if, you know, God is, you know, he the Bible says that, you know, the Holy Spirit led Jesus into the wilderness to be tested by Satan. So in a lot of times, God will allow things in order to get the rare jewel out of us that he's hidden in our hearts, which is Jesus and his Holy Spirit and you know, his love and compassion, the gifts of the Spirit. All those things are hidden within his Holy Spirit, within us, when we actually accept Jesus. So, you know, it's constantly like, you know, a resurrection, you know, even when we walk through deliverance, you know, for forgiveness and things like that. We're constantly growing and being in and going through sanctification and everything. But God wants us to be, again, mirror images of Jesus, and that's what his Holy Spirit does for us when we spend time with him. But he wants us to see him as he sees us, as that treasure, as when we, you know, taste and see how good he is. Like I said, I was in the kitchen and I was about to, you know, I got some water and I was gonna, you know, thinking about winding down, and was like, oh, I really need to release that word. And I was just like, you know, Lord, I'll release it tomorrow, you know, so I fix it up and release it and stuff like that. And he just put something on my heart where he came through for me when I really needed him. And next thing I knew, I just had my hands up high and I was just praising him and I was thanking him over and over again for his goodness and everything. And I was like, you know what, I'm going right now, because somebody needs to know how good he is. Somebody needs to know, no matter where you are at the moment, you know, if it's good and everything's great, thank him, you know. If you're in a trial, you know, thank him, because you're not there by yourself. You're hidden within Christ, and you're that pearl, you know what I'm saying, that treasure he died to give you. To give you resurrection life, and he loves you, and that's one thing, you know. I just had this encounter, and it was just so strong, and I was just saying, Lord, I promise I won't forget what you've done. I love you, and I thank you. I truly, truly thank you that, you know, I can even stand and come before you to testify, you know, and I, you know, it's like, the blessings and the promises that he's promised, you know, I'm still, you know, looking in expectation to walk in those things. But what I have is the treasure, the pearl, you know. It's like, again, the he's so good. It's just like he's, help us, Holy Spirit, help me here. It's like, again, the hidden treasures that he's hidden within our hearts, that life tries to suck our joy away from us, tries to take our peace and our love and our compassion and our kindness, all things that life tries to steal from us. God is saying, I've buried those things, and I'm looking to resurrect those in your heart and heal you and deliver you. And no matter what you've gone through, I'm going to go through those things with you. And but it does cost. It costs. And one of the things, when you go through things like that, you know, you kind of learn who you can trust, and you learn discernment and trust your instinct based on the Holy Spirit and the Word of God, and not just, you know, your own opinions and things like that. You move in the spirit, and that's what God says. Those that move by my spirit are his children, you know? So this is the word God gave me. And a lot of people, again, you know, the world may say, you know, again, it's you know, who you have around you and things like that and everything. But in this hour, and I'm just going to be honest, with everything we've gone through, everything the country's gone through with COVID and nations and stuff like that, I think it's a crazy person, a foolish person, like the Bible said, that wouldn't even be seeking the Lord in this time. I really, truly do. I think it's foolish, even if you didn't, you know, if you didn't know him or you your walk wasn't that deep with everything we've gone through. I mean, you know, be like, if you, you know, I want to know if you're real or not. You know what I'm saying? You would be just inquisitive enough to even try to say, you know, are you real? You know what I'm saying? You would be trying to find or get answers to questions and everything like that. And what's so great about Jesus is that he's not afraid of our questions. He wants us to ask and everything. I go back to, you know, Gideon, when God called Gideon, and Gideon was like, you know, he was hiding at that moment when God, you know, knocked on the door. He was hiding, trying to make bread where the Midianites wouldn't take it and everything, because they had betrayed God and they were going through such a rough time. He had to hide, and he was just like, well, where's the, you know, when God called him, he was like, well, where's the God our fathers told us about, that the God that saved us and the God that protect us or whatever, the things that we're going through, I don't know who that God is, you know, where is that, you know, when the angel, you know, of the Lord called upon him. So God is not afraid of us asking questions and everything like that. He loves that, you know. He knows everything about us. So we can do that. But in this hour, God truly wants us to be like him and be like in the parable, the merchant that finds the exquisite jewel and is so overjoyed and wants to hide it again till he can cultivate that relationship and you know, yeah, just have it all, you know? And it's a daily walk, but this is what God told me, because some of us have, again, through the grace of God, not by our own strength, but, you know, because God has called us, God has chosen us, and because he wants us to be that example for our families. And when I say families, I'm not just talking about blood family. You know, I'm just saying, you know, because the Bible talks about, you know, when they said, you know, your mother and your brother is at the door and stuff like that. Jesus was like, my mother and my brother are the ones that, you know, trust in God, that believes in God, that's walking in the way and everything, you know. So we have extended families, I guess is what I'm talking about. Not just, you know, your blood, but just those of us that are in Christ Jesus, you know, and everything. You know, just again, being that bride. God wants us to be the bride without a blemish, spot, or wrinkle. When he's getting us ready, you know, yes, we're getting ready for the return of, you know, of Jesus. And then I don't say that meaning, oh, he's going to come tomorrow. The Bible says nobody knows the time and everything. However, you know, I've had, you know, visions of, you know, my grandkids and stuff like that. And I trust God in everything. So, you know, and I've seen other people's grandkids that are much older than what God showed me mine were going to be and everything, as he had me pray. But again, our time is like a vapor, you know, our time is like a vapor, and we don't want to be the ones like the thief on the cross next to Jesus that didn't know him. God is so merciful that, you know, he does save people and give them passage into, you know, heaven, you know, at the end. But the thing is that you want to live a life knowing him now, and Because when you start, when you allow Jesus to truly come into your heart, then again, he lives through you. His Holy Spirit lives through you. And you're able to communicate and love other people, you know, rightly through the eyes of Jesus. And I'm not saying excuse bad things that they do and stuff like that, but know and trust and pray for them that God's going to turn around. Or when you stand in good standings, then God will bring the righteous judgment that needs, in the justice that needs to be.
In their life,
he's going to get justice, and then and he's going to love and promote you and give you all the blessings that come with the kingdom realm. You know, because again, when you get Jesus, you get everything. But anyway, so this is what I get off my soapbox. I'm just so, I'm in awe of him. And like I said, he's the reason I can, you know, I can even smile. He truly is. He's so good. God said, beware of the energy zappers. And that's what I named this. He said, people will tend to celebrate that which seems unattainable for them. They will migrate to the ones who have put the time and energy in to stay close to me. He said, discern the ones who are only looking to gain from the glory. What does that mean in world's terms? Be discerning of the people that didn't support you, that you know, maybe even lied or talked about you, whatever. And then when you come into your promotions and your things like this, then they want to celebrate and come or whatever. Remember, God looks at the hearts of people. You know, he looks at our hearts. He looks at our motives and things like that. So that's what God is saying, because, again, you know, there are seasons that God has people in your life and seasons that he separates. But the thing is that in this hour, God is truly separating the wheat from the tares. He is looking at hearts, and those people that didn't celebrate you, that talked about you, whatever, but, you know, then they're coming back around. What God is saying is they can hinder because their hearts weren't pure in the first place. They can come around, and then they want to zap your energy and things like that. So you need to still listen to God. You need to still have discernment and everything, because, again, like I said, you know, I found myself saying, Lord, I promise, you're going to be first in my prayer that through your Holy Spirit you keep me, you know, teachable and humble and everything. But that is what God is saying to us. He's telling us to be discerning. Those that have, like I said, have been sacrificing, that have been praying out, standing in the gap, praying and doing, you know, things, of, again, with the grace of God. But what he's asked you to do, you need to understand before you say yes to everything or whatever, you need to take it to God. And that's just what he's saying, you know, let him be first just like he is, you know, as, you know, he's bringing you out of your wilderness and stuff. But he said, again, stay close to me, use discernment of the ones looking to gain from the glory. This is a season that all should be seeking my understanding. All should be ready to move more into deeper revelation of who I am. Like, the, again, the scripture, the one that found the pearl was so excited. He buried it, and he wanted the whole field because he wanted to find out what cultivated that pearl, what that pearl, you know, how that pearl becomes so beautiful. You know what I'm saying? Think about a pearl being in a clam and in darkness and everything, but then by being cultivated and buried and nurtured and everything and not knowing, you know, not feeling good, not knowing what's going on, but then the light shines and it's polished and it becomes so beautiful and everything like that. So God is saying, again, use discernment. You know, that the soil that that pearl was cultivated in was the very oil and the word of God and the, you know, the spirit of God, you know what I'm saying? Being in a secret place, praying and then being on your knees and everything like that, you didn't gain, that didn't come easy. So don't give it away and don't let people just totally take advantage is what God is saying. Stay close to God because, again, God has, you know, places and connections and things that he wants to accomplish. We are at his delight. we are for Him, you know. And when you love someone, when you're in a love relationship, you know, whether it's a you know, someone you're going to marry and stuff like that, you want to please that person. You love them and everything. So it's no different with God and with us. So that's what He's saying. He's trying to give us, again, revelation, understanding, so all will be well. So again, He says that all should be seeking His understanding and everything, a deeper revelation. So many has cast their nets and cares on the wrong side of the boat, looking to obtain what can only be obtained through Me. What does that mean? Meaning that we're casting our nets into man and what man thinks. We're casting our nets into, you know, what somebody else is doing, you know, comparing what they're doing, and because they have success in this venture or whatever, we're jumping over there, but we never ask God if that's for us and things like that. You know what I'm saying? So we're just out there casting our nets, hoping that it's going to bring in something. And God is saying that the true purpose that I've called you to be and to walk in, you can only walk into that purpose and that life and that revelation. You can't walk in that listening to man. You have to come into the secret place. You have to, I'm the only person that can truly give you what you're missing. I'm the only person that can truly heal your heart and bring deliverance and the desires of your heart. I'm the only one that can truly do it. Now, God uses man and circumstances and things to get us everything that you know our hearts desire when we are in His will, you know. So He does use man and everything, but again, in other words, you don't have to suck up to man and things like that in order for them to open up a door, because God holds the hearts to kings and stuff. So many people, you know, have been disobedient anyway of what God has told them. That's why He's brought, especially in church and everything, which when I say this, I love church. I love to come together and everything. But just like the Sadducees and the Pharisees, they're the ones that crucified Jesus because, you know, they were envious, they were jealous, and they wanted, you know, God to be in the way that they thought God should be. And again, God is everything. He's in everything. You know what I'm saying? He's rivers of living waters. He's in fig trees, you know. He will manifest any way He wants to, but through the eyes and the heart of Jesus. Jesus is the gateway, you know. So, but man wants to think, you know, you have to be a certain way and things like that, you know. But again, God is so good. So anyway, God is saying that we're casting our nets on the wrong side of the boat, and we should be casting our nets within Him. And when we're in His Word, when we're spending time with Him, you know, sacrificing things for Him, then you're going to get and walk into your purpose. And He was saying, looking to obtain what can only be obtained through Me and My love and patience. God said He wants us to keep coming with a hungry heart for love, for His love. Keep bringing your offering. The aroma within my spirit, it's in the heart's position. So again, it's in the positions of our hearts. And when we spend time with God, Holy Spirit, when we spend time in His Word, and not in a legalistic way, but in a way to say, God, I don't understand everything, but I want a closer walk with You. I want to be healed. I want to be whole. I don't want to walk through and going around in circles. You know, I want more. You know, something's missing, you know, and I'm tired of looking, again, casting my nets on the wrong side of the boat, I don't, you know, to man and this group and this, you know, class and blah, blah, blah. You tell me where I should go. Point me. Be the lamp unto my feet like Your Word says You are. You know, I want to seek You. I truly want to be the merchant that found the precious pearl but buried it because He wanted to buy the whole field. So, you know, when you get a taste of Jesus, when you truly get a taste of Jesus and see His eyes, It's no way you can walk and be who you are, were before. It is just no way. You know, God is saying we can't be lukewarm anymore. We can't be closet Christians, meaning that, you know, God is speaking to you or whatever, but you're going to keep it all to yourself. He told us to what's told in the dark, you know, by his revelation. Tell it to the masses. Get it out there, because he wants people to know he's alive and he's speaking and he's moving, and he wants to change our lives. He wants to break strongholds, generational strongholds and everything. You find yourself, well, why am I not, you know, why I'm not married, why I'm not happy and everything. And then you look around and look back down your family line, and it's like, oh my gosh, at a certain age, that happened in all kind of generations, you know. But God is saying, no, I'm calling you, and I'm going to use you to change the trajectory of your, you know, ancestry, bloodline, and everything. I want to use you. Your name was written. You know, your name is written to be the one to say, no, my children and children's children's children will be free, and they're going to, you know, love and worship God and walk in his ways. You know, we truly have to lay down stones, I'm thinking about the stones that he told the Israelites to make so people would remember the tribes and everything. So not man's traditional, you know, traditional ways, but through God's way to make sure. All through the Bible, it's like the generations after, you know, a king maybe served for 40 years or whatever, and it's like after that the people forgot about even what the king did or how he served God and things like that. Memorial stones. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Jesus. We need to set up memorial stones. So and how do we do that? Start talking again to our kids, whether they want to hear it or not, but in a loving way. And when we get those grandbabies, when they're, I mean, just out of the womb, just pray over them and talk to them about Jesus in a loving way. You know what I'm saying? Viewing, you know, the past hurts as opportunities to walk in freedom and to truly, truly open our hearts, you know, to have conversations with people that don't look like us, don't act like us. But again, seeing people as people and seeing people, you know, as precious pearls like Jesus did, because he died for us. So, yeah. So, anyway, I'm off of my soapbox. I hope my rambling made sense to whoever. You know, I have to trust that, you know, it'll speak. If it spoke to one person, then, you know, I felt I did what God asked me to do and everything. And I bless you. Let me pray for you guys. Let's pray for us. You know, I thank you for the prayers that some people reach out and say, you know, that they, you know, the word spoke to their spirit and things like that and everything. So, you know, that's nice to hear and everything sometimes, you know. But Father, I just thank you. I thank you, God, that you are so good to us. You're so good that on this Thursday night you will stop us to come together to hear what you've said. Father, I pray that eyes were open, ears were open to just hear.
Not in a judgment
way or not in, you know, but just hear through your love that you want better for us and that you want us to spend time with you. That's what it boils down to, that you want us to spend time with you because you truly hold everything that we need. And through your delight, you freely give it
to us when we ask for wisdom
and understanding. You freely want to give it to us to to make us better, to make us secure and
feel loved and wanted and of Jesus.
Those that who have accepted thee as our Lord and Savior, Father. If there's someone on this broadcast that has not, but you predestined for them to be here at this very moment or to hear this broadcast, Father, I pray that when they do open their heart and accept you as their Lord and Savior, that you put the right people in their lives. And again, you give them morning. You give them gladness for their morning, Father, that you just bring a breath of fresh air into their lives, because that's what you want to do. I just pray for prosperity of the mind.
And hearts to be
renewed.
But again, trusting as we walk.
Father, this wonderful life that you privileged
us to have.
I pray that
Jesus'
name. Well, be blessed. Be blessed. Hello, beautiful Giselle. Hello. But you guys have a blessed evening.